All right, we are on, and we're gonna start off on Extro, see what he does. And first map, Ironworks, I believe it's called. And we are not on Extro, we're on Ooze. Let's see where it goes. Yeah, the important part on this map is, of course, the red armors and the rails. And as you saw, they just stressed out first to the rail. And I think that's, yeah, that's because it's such a big and open map. You need the rail advantage at mid, and here you see him instantly going again for the red. And yeah, for the enemy red, obviously, but the 9. Yeah, because the red is so important on this map, both as a defender and as an attacker. Because, yeah, obviously, I'm gonna be Captain Obvious. The one with the armor has the advantage. There, I said it. But, alright, so I'm gonna try to find Extro again. Yeah, oh, we had a power up even. Let's follow the power up. Yeah, and it's Extro. So let's see if he can do anything with it. So, we also, yeah, okay, this is good. Regen and a red armor, even if it's his own teams. But, with a coordinate and attack, they can make something happen. Oh, he's gonna wait for this. Oh. Yeah. Alright, this is ideal. He has everything he needs once. Everything he can hope for. Oh, and even better. Okay, okay, this is looking good for Extro. Even though the team communication from the Russians seems to be working fine, this is looking, yeah, a solid attack. But Latrome, yeah, too strong. But a solid try there by Extro. I mean, he did everything he should. He stacked up. He got the regen. He even got the enemy red. Yeah, you see, this is how important the reds are on this map. He actually doubled rocket jumped instead of running around just to get it. But so far, it's been a pretty slow map. Well. Yeah, and that's also on this map. Since the shaft and rail are pretty poorly located for the defenders, it's very very common for attackers to bring those guns back to the defenders, so they can defend properly. At least the shaft, the rail is a bit easier to get without getting too much out of position. But yeah, right now it's just a big fucking clusterfuck, and. I think we need to see more runs like Extro's. We need to see, yeah, the next power up. That's the times that's gonna be really interesting when he can stack up. Yeah. Oh, hit! We got the flag. That's so much more. Okay, let's see. Oh, and he has a stack. But Abso, oh, Abso takes him down. So we're back on Extro with the power up. And yeah. Red armor spawn. Oh no, he should have waited. It spawns in just a few seconds, but he wants to help out his defender. Alright, so, yeah. Again, you see there, he drops his shaft before leaving, because it's not that easy to get as a defender on this map. For some reason, he even dropped his rockets. That's really unnecessary. But alright, so this is what I dislike about, I'm gonna say it out loud right now. I dislike slow CTF, I mean VQL and VQ3 CTF, because of the pace of it. It is not tactical, it's slow. I mean, I fucking loved and rocked in CPM CTF because of the pace of it. It was fast, it was, you know, yeah. Fast-paced stuff, always happening. Yeah, it was amazing fun. But here, yeah, you have to wait for a super stack. You get double railed, and you have to start over every time. I mean, sure, you can just not get double railed, but yeah, you get points. This is pretty much what's happening, and it's about spawn luck, getting your defenders or attackers to spawn at the right place when your flag is on the move, and stuff like that. So. Yeah, and am I wrong or no? Right, Japanese castles was picked like as map 2, so that was picked. Yeah, And Hate Me has been doing a terrible job, yeah, this last minute that I've been specking him. Alright, FX got it, but he's... Alright, let's see. Maybe he can do something with it. Yeah. Oh, Extra got the flag, but... Oh, this is huge. Oh, this is really huge. This is 1-0. And then we go straight back to the power-up carry, but we're very nice there by Extra. I'm not sure why, if the Russian team put too much focus to get the power-up or what happened, but yeah. 1-0 Germany. I was gonna say something really inappropriate there. I think you can guess what. But I'm happy for you, Germany. Yes, that's politically correct. A very tactically correct play here by FX, dropping guns, getting guns, keeping stack, getting. Yeah, but you see, even with all of this, he can't attack. He doesn't feel like it's worth attacking just yet. And that's what makes this so slow. Oh, very nice by Russia. Are they attacking? Is this a coordinated attack or a silly defense move? It's a coordinated attack! Ooh, and oh my god, that he hit his teammate there! Oh. If he hadn't hit Kaz right there in the air, that would have been so different. Oh my god, so unlucky. I'm gonna stick on FX for a while, because, yeah, he seems to be knowing what to do. And, yeah. It's still, yeah, exactly, he gets this, he's gonna go get, well, he should have gotten the red, but he's gonna go for the power-up. Support here. Yeah, here we go. Power-up goes to Germany again. And this is what I meant earlier about them not only being over cocky Clan Arena players. They have some really experienced CTF players too. I think Extra is, yeah, at one of them. And I think, yeah, that can make a huge difference. Oh, so close! Oh, Latromi! Oh, very nice by Latromi. Oh, nice try by Extra, but that shaft by Latromi, just nailing him. Gluing him to the wall. That was perfect. Oh, a nice hit me there, denying the red armor. I mean, one way of denying it. He did take it, Extra, but he didn't get to use it. But okay, I'm gonna switch back to FX because right now Team Germany could play far more defensive than Team Russia can afford. I mean, it's still early in the game, but yeah, they need to even it up, just like as in Duel or in TDM or in whatever mode you're playing. If you're down, you need to get up. And we have a flag carrier, and it's Extra. And he should really... Oh no, he didn't use his Stimpak! Extra. Ooh, Abso has a flag. And let's see... Oh, he's a stacked one. And Abso has a great aim too. This is dangerous. I think this will be cap number two. Yeah, here we go. 2-0 for Germany, probably. Unless something really... Ooh. Nah. Yeah. 2-0 for Germany. Yeah. Whoever predicted 3-0 Russia, Bieber, here we go. not always follow red players. I'm not always following red players, I'm following FX like half of the game. And what do you mean red players? Oh, god damn it. Am I that stupid? Was I just trolled? Yeah, if so, fuck you. If otherwise, I just missed a flag carrier, but nothing happened, so... Yeah. Oh, I think PH is a defender. If there's anything more boring than watching CTF, it's watching a CTF defender. I mean, Sure, it can be fun to play. You get to just shoot at people, kill people. Yeah, Quake. It's funny. But a defender in Capture a Flag is really just standing there. And this is the deal. Even with 200, 100 and 100, like some 100 health, 100 armor collectively, he can't attack or he won't attack. And I understand him. Sure, he wants everything before he goes. But that's why this is so slow. That's why it's kind of dull for most people. At least for the people who enjoy Quake because of the pace of it, because CTF kind of kills it. And oh my god, the German team just locked the data down. They knew he was coming, they knew he had a lot of stuff, and they just triple shafted him down. Like a white chick in a Negro gangbang movie. Oh, two easy frags, nice. But yeah, power up coming up. Let's see if they can do something about it. Or with it, rather. And Extro gets it. I mean, Extro has so far, to me, been a player of the game. He got the first cap, he helped out at the second cap, he has been at every single power-up. And he has been playing extraordinary. But now we have a flag runner, and it's Hate Me. And, oh, Extro! Ooh, they saved him. They saved him. He saved them. Him and his mate there, Abso. So very nice play there by Germany. Almost losing a flag to make it 2-1. Because psychologically, you know, being down by two is so much worse than being down by one. And did he really need to use his medkit? That was confusing. I think he's stressed, but whatever. He's the Capture the Flag player, I'm not. I'm just a silly TDMer. Yeah. As of yet, I want to say MVP Extro, but we'll see. I don't really give that much credit to defenders in Capture the Flag, because as I said, it's really just about positioning and aiming. And yeah, that's called Clan Arena. So the real hard part in Capture Flag is attacking, and so far Extra has been doing it extraordinary, if I may say so. Yes, you get the pun, thank you. So we're closing up on power up time, even though it's just a region on this map. That can make such a huge difference, especially if you have armor and a medikit and everything. Let's see, an Abso, one Abso with one power up. But he's a very, if anyone on this server is a very clan arena-ish player, it's Abso. So I think this will be a very passive play. He went for the enemy medkit, but I think, yeah, he's not really gonna do anything with it. But let's see, he might. Because he just denied two players going to the red. But we have a flag carrier, and that's always priority. But I think, yeah, this is what's gonna happen. He's gonna die. Come on, Abso. Oh, of course. Yeah. That was what was gonna happen. They chased the flag carrier and Abso came in with a full stack, a medikit and a Rian. And the Rian ran out just in time, so I couldn't swap to him in time. Sorry for that. And yeah, they couldn't just kill him. There was no chance. They shafted him right through the mid and a 3-0 to Germany. And this must be a tactical timeout from Team Russia. I think it's a bit late in the game, actually. I don't think they will take back three flags in 6 minutes. Prepare to fight. But yeah, Hate Me, do as you like. Fight. I mean, now especially, Germany can play not a passive game, but a defensive game. Yeah, no, I'm not gonna ult Shab, so I'm not gonna try me. That's gonna go to... Let's see FX. They need someone like him to change things up. Maybe they're swapping up something like trying one defender and three attackers. Oh, 4 HP. Come on, Ooze! Come on! You can do it! Nope. I wanna go back to FX. Because, still, it's Russia who needs to do something. Germany can just sit back and relax and they will win. But Russia can't. So, yeah. Yeah, what Venom said there, 2-0 up, here we go, 4-man defend. That's pretty much what you can do in this, not 4-man defend, I mean, just like that, but pretty much playing like it. I mean, you can't just stop attacking full time, but you can be so much more defensive, you don't need to take risks for... oh, you don't need to take any special risks or anything for to get captures like Russia needs to do now. You can just play your ordinary game. If your defenders call you back, you go back because you don't need more captures. And especially when this is as slow as it is, I mean, they won't take these many flags back. Black? Did I just say flags black? They won't take these many flags back within a time, so yeah, this is game over. And I keep forgetting, sorry guys, I need to check which one is which. Okay, so that's 5 is power up, 4 is flag, got it. I mean, it's my first time streaming capture flag, so you're gonna have to cut me some slack at least. An extra, are you really gonna stand here for 10 more seconds? Because someone will come out of the teleporter. Yep. Yeah, that worked out like a charm. Yeah, it's unlucky on the timings. I don't even know if CTFers time the CTF attackers, or if they just hope. They're like, yeah, this might spawn soon. It's like, no, it's not like in Duel or in TDM, and when it's like, yeah, red is 48, late 48, not early 48, so we can't jump on it early or 48, because we'll die or shit. It's like, meh, I'll take it when it's up. It's fine. Alright, let's see, FX got it. And as I said earlier, I think he's the man who needs to do this for Russia, but I think it's far too late. They won't get the flag a minute. If they do, Germany just forfeit the next maps, because you don't deserve it. Oh, that was so nice! Such a movie frag from FX there. FX, by the way, is also the old player known as Reika and MC Vagina. And something else, I can't remember. But he was banned permanently, but Sinker cleared his name and said that no, he's not supposed to be. So here he is, and he is a good player. He's gonna die though, but he is a good player. Yeah, so first map to Germany, which is nice because I don't think Germany will win 3-0. I thought Russia might could have, but as I also said, I think Germany must have at least one home map that they can win, which means I get to see spider crossings. Yep, just wait for the red armor. I think they should rename CTF to like Power Up Red Armor Game or something. Red Power Up. I mean, okay, on this map, it's all about red armor and the red power up, which is Rian. So, just call the map red. Oh, my flag carrier. And it's Extro, my MVP. Is he gonna... Oh, he's railable, he's railable. Oh, oh, let's see what happens. Ooh, PH. Is he gonna make it? Yes, he is. 4-0. Alright. Not the, okay, it was totally unnecessary, but yeah. Congratulations, Germany. 1-0. And that's also a psychological thing. What's so important about winning the coin toss? You get to pick your map first, which they did, and they picked what I guess is a strong map for them. And they are up 1-0 in maps, and that's gonna give them an edge on the second map. And let's see if FX can get a cap here, because the Russian flag isn't at home. Both flags are on the run. No, there's not gonna be a cap for Team Russia, and that's also a bummer. Red wins. So, well played both teams, but congratulations Germany for the first game.